Hi, I'm Stephan Meier. I teach the course strategy class and an elective on the future of work at Columbia Business School.
And I'm Todd Jick. I've been 18 years at Columbia Business School teaching organizational change and co-teaching with Professor Bruce Usher, Bridging the American Divides. Now I'm collaborating with Stephan on this very interesting project about the future of work and the relationship of change management to that.
We're here today to really focus on the human side of human-machine interaction and how to implement AI in a way that creates this human-centric future of work.
There are a lot of failure stories, and you and I teach cases which are mostly failures, problem situations, etc. When we find a success story, you and I know we just grab it. And we found one in this Morgan Stanley example where they introduced AI. Can you tell us a little bit more about what happened there? What they went about doing that was so successful?
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Todd. Yeah, Morgan Stanley is an interesting example because when you think about wealth management and financial advisors, you know, you think about all the activities, tasks that the financial advisor does. You know, he or she gets up in the morning, has a coffee, and then, like, reads the news, digests the news, think about, like, how can I adapt it to your portfolio? What is, like, ideal for your portfolio? Sends you an email, whatever, has some lunch, whatever. If you look at all those activities, a lot of them, the machine can do really well, much better. I mean, the machine doesn't sleep, actually already digested the news, already figured out what is, like, the right aspect. So Morgan Stanley was really thinking about how can we augment our financial advisors and implement it in a way that doesn't freak them out.
Let's just stop there. So they actually have a good idea. It makes a lot of sense. There's a business case for it, and there's a potential ROI. But now my concern is, did they introduce it in a way in which people are using it?
Absolutely, yeah. So they have a good idea. They call it next best action, which gives recommendation to the financial advisor what is the next thing they should do with their client. But you're absolutely right. The implementation is now key. Because as a financial advisor, I'm worried. Are they just taking my job? Like, now I need to, it all works well, what I'm doing already.
What else are they going to automate?
Yeah, why do I need to change? And so on and so forth. So they actually took, I think, without actually knowing your five eyes, you know, did a lot of aspects that really look very similar to the eye. You know, they heavily informed. They were like, had long meetings, many meetings. So Jeff McMillan, the head of technology at Wealth Management, now the head of AI of Morgan Stanley, firm-wide, said like he had hundreds of meetings with financial advisors.
I love hearing this. And again, people are said, I did one meeting, I told them they should know. Hundreds of meetings.
Hundreds of meetings. In fact, after a while, he would bring in financial advisors who already bought in and experienced the advantage, and they told the stories.
Early adopters selling the story to other people.
Absolutely.
Very credible.
Absolutely. It's like when you look, it was pretty clear in all the communication that they don't want to take their jobs away. In fact, you can look him up online, like basically every sentence he says, like, we want to augment and not replace. So assuring their employees that, you know, I'm not asking your job, I want to make your job
much and by
better.
The way, in some instances, that's the case, but they don't reassure. So people assume the negative, they get very fearful. The reassurance has to occur once, twice, three times, because people want to believe it,
right.
And it takes that. So
right.
That's very helpful.
Right. They like supported it also with research they did internally to figure out, you know, because, you know, the financial advisor wants to say, well, you should say that, you know, why you believe that we can actually augment. So they did research on, like, what tasks should a financial advisor do if they have like 10 more minutes at the end of the day. Turns out those 10 more minutes, you should make a call to a client. You should talk to a client. Now they often don't have those 10 minutes or those half an hour or those hours.
I call that an incentive. I mean, they're gonna get a benefit from that.
Yes.
They're gonna have a stronger client relationship, presumably more and more revenue from it, all to the benefit of those 10 minutes and more.
Absolutely, absolutely. And then another of your eyes, you know, instruct is like two parts. Like one is, there is mistrust. You know, why do I know that the recommendation that comes through that system, you know, I can trust that? And what do I do with it? And so they spend a lot of time in actually helping their employees to trust the system and making sure that they understand, you know, they can always overrule it. If they're unhappy, they have full agency in using it. They actually never made it mandatory and just believed that the system is so helpful to the employees that they actually will use it themselves without actually making it mandatory.
So there's a new MIT study that shows that including employees early and often pays off. Were employees, you're implying it, included in this whole process?
Absolutely. I think what Jeff McMillan says, you know, there are two aspects. One is it needs top down. It needs actually buy-in from the top. If the leadership is not on board, all the changes that they wanted to implement is not going to happen. But the more important part is like involving actually the financial advisors, getting their feedback, you know, involving them in what they're afraid of, and then adapting as a result to the implementation strategy, but also to like what the product actually looks like. What do they actually need on a day-to-day basis?
You know, the irony of all this, Stephan, is that when we teach success stories in the classroom, the students say, I would have done exactly that. Everybody will do that. But the reality is, it doesn't occur this way. This is an exceptional story. It's why we wanted to showcase it. And it gives us hope and confidence that other companies can do this kind of thing.
Absolutely. And it also, you know, it's hard to do because it actually, you know, the hundreds of meetings, all the contact, that just doesn't happen when you write a nice deck. That actually has like every single day, you need to do all those eyes almost at the same time and convince your workforce that it's worthwhile.
So dare we say to our audience listening to this that there's leadership involved and there's an investment in leadership and a skill in leadership that's required to make this successful.
Absolutely.